Good morning, children. So we had started with the chapter Plant Kingdom, and we were discussing about the methods of reproduction and also the economic significance of the different uses of algae. I think we covered that, the different uses of algae, and we just started with the different classes of algae. I think just completed the different uses, the different benefits of algae, and we were about to start with the different classes. So today we will be learning about the major classes coming under algae. Just like we learned in the case of fungi, different classes are there, and there are chances that you get confused. So mainly you need to focus on the cell wall, the methods of reproduction, the storage form of food produced. So all that, it is better if you can, in the textbook already a table is given comparing the pigments present, their cell wall, storage form of food. So it can be asked, this is also a repeatedly asked question, compare the cell wall, storage form of food, or reproduction in these three divisions, or these three classes. Anyhow, it can be asked. So whenever you learn some divisions or classes coming under the same category, make a table and you compare it and learn. Otherwise, you will get confused. Okay, so we'll proceed with the different classes of algae. So before I proceed, our usual routine, let us learn what have you understood or whether you have revised your previous day's portions. So we'll start with whom? We'll start with Punya. Okay, Punya, tell me some uses of algae.
Some of them are hydrocolloids and are used as thickening agents.
Some of them are hydrocolloids, or using some of them we can produce.
We prepare hydrocolloids.
Yes.
And it is used as thickening agent in jellies.
Ah, yes.
And ice cream sometimes.
Okay, okay. Then another use. One more use. Ah.
They are used by astronauts as food supplements because they are rich in proteins.
Okay, can you give an example of a, Nandana, tell me an example of an algae used as food supplement by space travelers.
Chlorella.
Chlorella, okay. Another use, Gayatri, one more use, can you say?
At least half of the carbon dioxide fixation is done by algae.
And they will increase the amount of?
Oxygen dissolved in water.
Yes, good. So we'll proceed to our today's topic, that is different classes of algae. The names can be confusing. So as I used to tell you, please don't keep today's portions for tomorrow to learn. Today itself, if you cover, if you go systematically, it won't be difficult. Otherwise, you will have to struggle. This is from seeing students for several years, I'm telling you this. There is no point in complaining towards the end that, so nothing is, nothing I could remember, I'm forgetting, these terms are confusing. So all that you can solve by learning your daily lessons. That is the only solution. So algae can be categorized into three main classes based on their color. Green algae, brown algae, red algae. Chlorophyceae. Chlorophyll indicates green color. So chlorophyceae, green algae. Phaeophyceae, brown algae. Rhodo, remember red. So if you can remember rhodophyceae and chlorophyceae, definitely you can remember phaeophyceae. There won't be confusion. Rhodophyceae, red algae. Chlorophyceae, green algae, and phaeophyceae. These are the three major classes of algae. Coming under algae, so algae comes under plant kingdom. The first division coming under plant kingdom is algae or talophyta, and algae can be subdivided into three main classes based on the pigment present or the color of the algae: chlorophyceae, phaeophyceae, and rhodophyceae. Here you can see some pictures of these three categories: green algae, brown algae, and red algae. Some figures are given. Now let's see about the different features of the first one. We'll start with the first class, that is chlorophyceae. They can come in different forms. It can be unicellular. It can be colonial. Colonial means they form colonies. Several alga will form colonies. Or it can be filamentous structure in the form of a ribbon or filaments. So they come in different forms. We are learning about the first one, first class green algae, chlorophyceae. They are single celled and they can form colonies. And filamentous forms are also found. And their color is grass green. They are having green color and the pigments present are chlorophyll A and B. You have learned about chlorophyll, but you have not learned about the subdivisions. There are actually five types: chlorophyll A, B, C, D, and E. Chlorophyll A and B are the most common, found in all higher plants and algae. C found in diatoms, and D in only in red algae, and E in some golden algae. All those specifications no need to learn, but you should know that chlorophyll has got different subcomponents like A, B, C, D, E, etc. And this particular algae is rich in chlorophyll A and B, and these pigments are present in the organelles known as chloroplast, the green colored plastids known as chloroplast. Hope you know what is meant by plastid. You have learned about different type of plastids in class 9. Chromoplast, chloroplast, leucoplast. So chloroplasts are green colored plastids. And the pigment you should know, because you are going to learn about the pigments in these three different classes. So that has to be underlined. If you're writing notes, please underline and keep chlorophyll A and B. Okay. Then the chloroplast, that can come in different forms. The shape of the chloroplast, these plastids can be in different shapes. It can be discoid, disc shaped, or it can be plate like, or it can form a network, you call it as reticulate, or it can be in the form of a cup or spiral, ribbon shape. It can come in different forms in different species. I'll repeat once again. They are single cell, they can be filamentous form, and they form groups known as colonies. And their color is green due to the presence of chlorophyll A and B. The pigment is present in organelles known as chloroplast. And chloroplasts come in different shapes. So depending upon the type or the species of algae, it can be discoid, plate like, which means there is no definite shape. It can come in different shapes in different species: discoid, plate like, reticulate means forms a network, cup shape, spiral shape, ribbon shape. So some of the shapes you can see in the picture given on your left side, and some of the organisms examples for chlorophyceae are also shown. Now next is the storage form of food. That is also another important aspect which distinguishes it from other classes. The food is stored in the form of proteins or starch or even as oil droplets. Storage form of food is protein, starch or oil droplets. And they are equipped with a special type of structures. Some storage bodies, you call them as pyrenoids. So pyrenoids are found in chlorophyceae, and it is meant for storing proteins and starch, and you find them, the exact or the location where they are found is inside the chloroplast. So chloroplasts are provided with pyrenoids. What are pyrenoids? Some storage structures. What do they store? Starch and proteins. Apart from that, some of them can even store oil droplets. So what is the storage form of food? You should know. Proteins, starch, oil droplets. And coming to the cell wall. Cell wall also needs to be stressed because it is different in different classes. The cell, you know that generally the cell wall in plants, it is made up of cellulose. And here they have an inner cellulose layer and an outer pectose. Pectose is also another carbohydrate. Inner cellulose, outer pectose. And examples are Chlamydomonas, Volvox, Eulothrix, Spirogyra and Chara. Chlamydomonas there you can see, you might be remembering, looks like a coconut. In the previous figure I had shown. Let me see some. This is a picture of a Chlamydomonas, and here the the green colored part, if you check, you can find that it is cup shaped. And Spirogyra, you're familiar, it's a ribbon shaped one. Volvox is something which forms colonies. It's an algae which form colonies. And pyrenoid, see the figure given, pyrenoid, some storage bodies present within the chloroplast. Chloroplast is cup shaped. One example for an organism, an algae with cup shaped chloroplast is Chlamydomonas. So that was about green algae. The microscopic view of Chlamydomonas you can see. Then Volvox, a colony of Volvox. So several colonies are being formed. Then you can see Eulothrix and Spirogyra. Both of them are in the filamentous form. In the previous slide, we saw filamentous form, colonial form. So Spirogyra and Eulothrix, filament. You can see it as ribbon-shaped or filamentous structures. And Spirogyra, if you notice, you will find spiral-shaped chloroplast. Then Volvox, it is forming filamentous structures. So that was about... Now, Chara is also shown. The picture of Chara is also seen over there. And Chlorophyceae. Next, we are moving on to the methods of reproduction. Any doubt with the previous slide? Any doubts with the previous slide? The main points what we discussed about Chlorophyceae are that they are green colored. Pigments are chlorophyll A and B. Present in chloroplast and scattered in the chloroplast, specialized storage bodies are present, which you call it as pyrenoids, which store starch and protein. Apart from that, some algae even store oil granules. Then about their cell wall, inner cellulose and outer pectose layer. Clear? Then now we are moving on to the methods of reproduction. Vegetative reproduction is also found in Chlorophyceae, and it takes place by means of fragmentation or spore formation. So spore formation and fragmentation are the two methods of vegetative reproduction in green algae. Now moving on to asexual reproduction. It's by means of spores, zoospores, flagellated zoospores, and they are produced in specialized fruiting bodies known as zoosporangia or zoosporangium singular. Now, sexual method of reproduction, that is by the fusion of gametes. And in our previous class, we learned about the differences between isogamous and isogamous and oogamous fusion. So once again, the methods of reproduction, it carries out asexual, sexual, and vegetative reproduction. Vegetative reproduction is by means of fragmentation and spore formation. And asexual reproduction by means of zoospores, which are provided with flagella, and they are produced in zoosporangia, whereas sexual reproduction is with the help of gamete fusion, the fusion of gametes, and it can be isogamous and isogamous and oogamous. Isogamous means fusing gametes are similar in size, and isogamous means that type of fusion, the fusing gametes will be dissimilar in size. And oogamous, it is a fusion between a large non-motile female gamete with a smaller motile male gamete, that is oogamous. Any doubts? Any doubt you have? I'm waiting for your response. Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No. You want any slide to be seen once again?
No.
No. No. Okay. So we discussed about, we just named the three different classes and we started the first one. We completed the first one. The three classes of algae are, Lydia, which are the three classes? I told you, I gave you a trick to remember it easily, you know. At least one. Which one we finished just now in detail? Don't demotivate me like this, children. Be attentive. Only those words, even explanation I did not ask. Didier, can you say? At least in terms of color, you say. Your mic is not working or what? I can't hear you. Nidhi? Which are the three?
Chlorophyce.
Don't read. If you are reading better, you don't say.
Chlorophyce, phenophyce, rhodophyce.
Phaeophyce. Okay. Chloro. Chloro is for green algae. Rhodophyce for red algae. And the third one? Phaeophyce for brown algae. Chlorophyce, rhodophyce, and Phaeophyce. Phaeophyce, rhodophyce, and chlorophyce. Then we learned about the green colored algae. Name the pigments present in chlorophyce. Meenakshi, which are the pigments present?
Chlorophyll A and B.
Chlorophyll A and B. What is the storage form of food? Malavika? How do they store food?
In pyrenoids.
In pyrenoids. But what do they store?
Protein and starch.
And one more thing. Certain algae will even store?
Oil.
Oil granules or oil droplets also will be stored. And then we learned about their cell wall. What is special about their cell wall, Nivin?
They have a rigid cell wall made of inner cellulose.
I can't hear. Need little more clarity in what you're speaking.
They are rigid cell wall made of an inner cellulose layer and an outer pectoral layer.
Reading from somewhere? Reading from somewhere? No. Oh. Okay. They have got a rigid cell wall made up of inner
and
inner cellulose and outer
pectoral layer.
Outer pectoral and inner cellulose. Anthony, which are the different methods of reproduction in algae? Anthony, video need to be turned on. You see others? Can you tell Anthony which are the three methods of reproduction?
Three methods.
Vegetative reproduction, then?
Vegetative.
Normally, which are the methods of reproduction? Which you have learned in 10th? Main methods of reproduction. Oh?
Sexual reproduction.
And?
Asexual reproduction.
So vegetative reproduction, sexual reproduction, and asexual reproduction. And vegetative reproduction takes place by Evelyn. Vegetative reproduction takes place by which method?
Fragmentation and spore formation.
And name the asexual spores here. Michael, name the asexual spores.
Flagellated zoospores.
Which spores?
Flagellated,
but what is the name?
Zoospores,
good. And which are the three types of sexual reproduction happening here? Sania?
Isogamy, oogamy, and
anisogamy.
Okay,
good. So shall we proceed to the next one? No doubts in the first one, no? So points to be stressed, cell wall, storage form of food, pigments present, reproduction. Okay. We are moving on to the second one, Phaeophyceae or brown algae. They are marine, means they are found in sea or salty water. And they too show so much of variations in their size and form. You can find both extremes over here. Hope you remember when in general we were speaking about algae, I told that some of them can reach, can form massive body. They will develop massive body, and I told the example kelps. So here in this particular class, you can find both extremes, simple branched filamentous forms to massive forms, profusely branched, massive, huge body, plant body they have got, known as kelps, 100 meters in height. So you can assume 100 meters in height, and at the same time, we have very simple filamentous branched forms also. So both extremes are found here. And coming to the pigments present, here the pigments present are chlorophyll A, chlorophyll C, carotenoids and xanthophylls. Chlorophyll A, in the previous one it was chlorophyll A and B. Here chlorophyll A, C, carotenoids and xanthophylls. And carotenoids, actually they are responsible for yellow, orange, red color of the plant parts, like tomato, pumpkin, carrot, and even in animals, shrimps, lobsters, salmon, they have that characteristic yellowish, reddish, or orangish color because of the presence of carotenoids. And xanthophylls, xanthophyll is responsible for yellow color. Actually, xanthophylls come under carotenoids. Carotenoids includes carotenes and xanthophylls. So xanthophyll is actually coming under carotenoids. I don't know why they have written like this. Anyway, since it is given in the text. Oh,
will you explain those carotenoids points again?
Yes, I will. So these also are pigments. So just like chlorophyll, carotenoids and xanthophylls are also pigments. And carotenoids are responsible for the yellow, orange and red color. Because you might have seen different animals and different fruits and vegetables with these colors, like carrot, pumpkin, oranges, then if you take tomatoes, then animals like fish, salmon fish, then shrimps, lobsters, they have that any of the shades of this yellow, orange, red. All those are due to the presence of this pigment carotenoids. Okay, and carotenoids, it has got two main groups, carotenes and xanthophylls, but in your textbook that is not mentioned. So carotenes and xanthophylls, carotenes and xanthophylls come under carotenoids, and xanthophyll is responsible for yellow color, specifically for that yellow color. Okay, but in your textbook it is given as two separate pigments. Okay, you want me to repeat it again, Punya?
No, ma'am.
Is that clear? Okay.
Yes.
So chlorophyll A, C, carotenoids and xanthophylls. So carotenoids and xanthophylls, they give yellow, red, orange color. So different parts of animals as well as plant parts are in these colors because of the presence of these pigments. So once again, the pigments present are chlorophyll A, C, carotenoids and xanthophylls. And depending upon the presence of fucoxanthin. Fucoxanthin is a type of xanthophyll pigment. It has got different subdivisions. So xanthophylls, it indicates a group of pigments. So xanthophyll pigment, one such pigment is fucoxanthin. And depending upon the amount of fucoxanthin present, these brown algae, they come in different shades, starting from olive green to brown color. So depending upon the concentration or the amount of fucoxanthin present, they come in different shades of brown, starting from olive green to brown. Okay, I'll repeat the points once again. So we had proceeded to brown algae, the second class. They are marine, and as I told you, in terms of size and form, they show too much of variation. They show the two extremes. We can even find massive plant bodies as well as very simple filamentous forms too. Example for a simple form is Ectocarpus. An example for a huge an algae with a huge plant body, Scelps, it comes to around 100 meters in height. Then the pigments present are chlorophyll A, C, carotenoids and xanthophylls. Whereas whenever you learn it, you should compare with what we discussed in the previous one, chlorophyll A and B in green algae. And coming to the color, they come in different shades of brown, starting from olive green to brown, depending upon the amount of the pigment fucoxanthin. It's a type of xanthophyll pigment. The xanthophyll pigment fucoxanthin can be present in varying amounts in different species. So accordingly, their color also will be different. So Ectocarpus and Kelps, the picture of both you can see. Okay, next one. About the storage form of food. Now we learned about the pigments. Now next is the storage form of food. Here the food is stored in the form of complex carbohydrates, laminarin and mannitol. laminarin and mannitol, whereas the storage form of food was protein, starch and oil granules in the case of the first one. But here the storage form of food is laminarin and mannitol. Don't worry about the names, these are actually carbohydrates. No need to think what type of substance it is, they are just carbohydrates, a complex form of carbohydrates. Now moving on to the cell wall. Cell wall, in the previous one, in green algae we learned inner cellulose, outer pectose. Here they have inner cellulose and it is covered. A cellulose wall is there, which is covered by a gelatinous covering. A gelatinous covering made out of algin. Algin is a polysaccharide. It has got a gelatinous coating made out of algin. And the protoplast. You know the difference between protoplasm and protoplast. Protoplasm means nucleus plus cytoplasm, which you have learned in your lower class. But when nucleus, cytoplasm plus the plasma membrane is also included, you call it as, I think this year itself we learned, protoplast. And it consists of plastids, a central vacuole and nucleus. The protoplast in brown algae consists of plastids, a central vacuole and nucleus. Now coming to their plant body. You can see in the figure given there, the plant body consists of three main parts. So its plant body consists of three main parts: a holdfast, a frond, and also a stalk. So stalk is meant for attachment, because to connect the frond with the substratum, they need a structure, we call it a stipe or a stalk. So that is there. Then there is a hold fast. It is with the help of that it gets attached to the substratum, and the leaf like part. So this is known as a frond. Okay, different types are given. In each of that there will be a stipe, a hold fast, a stalk like structure, that is known as stipe. Then with the help of which they are getting attached to the substratum, that is known as hold fast. Hold fast will attach it to the substratum. Then there is a stalk like structure leading to a leaf like part, which you call it as frond. These are the three main parts of brown algae. And examples include Ectocarpus, Dictyota, Laminaria, Sargassum and Fucus. You can see the pictures of different brown algae here. Okay children, Ectocarpus is also shown, then Sargassum, this is also a Sargassum. Okay, methods of reproduction we are not learning today. Once again, Sargassum, Ectocarpus, Laminaria, Fucus, Dictyota. So these are the different examples. Any doubt? Any doubt, children? So once again, I'll just repeat what we said so far. The second group, these are marine forms. They show so much of variation in their size and form. We can see elementous form to the profusely branched one. The pigments present are chlorophyll AC, carotenoids and xanthophylls, and their color can vary depending upon the pigment present, the xanthophyll pigment, that is fucoxanthin. And the storage form of food is laminarin and mannitol. Both of them are complex carbohydrates. Cell wall made out of cellulose and covered with a gelatinous covering made out of algin. And the protoplast consists of plastid, central vacuole and nucleus. Plant body has got three main parts: a leaf-like part known as frond, connecting it to holdfast. There is a stalk, and holdfast is a structure with which they get attached to the substratum. They'll be fixed somewhere, whether it is the sea floor or wherever it is, to get attached to the substratum. The holdfast will help. So that was about the second class. So quickly tell me about the different features. Donna, tell me about the pigments present in brown algae. Fast, don't take too much time. Chlorophyll?
Chlorophyll AC.
Carotenoids.
And xanthophylls.
Xanthophylls. Which is the pigment, main pigment that decides its color? Alvin? The main pigment that decides the color of brown algae, based on which pigment it comes in different shades?
Sandophyll.
Which sandophyll pigment? I want the name of the sandophyll pigment starting with F. Who will tell me? Steffi?
Fucoxanthin.
Alvin, which is that?
Fucoxanthin.
Fucoxanthin. Okay. Then tell me about the cell wall. Nia, what about the cell wall?
Vegetative cell wall covered by a gelatinous covering.
Okay, cellulose cell wall covered by a gelatinous covering, which is made up
of algae.
Very good. And only that we covered now today. And one more point, which are the storage forms of food here? Anna, which are the storage forms of food in brown algae? Two complex carbohydrates. Which are they?
Laminarin and mannitol.
Very good. Okay. Thank you, children. We'll continue next class.
Thank you, ma'am.